Welcome back to Real Culture. It's your boy JF, and I got my man's Rob Valentine. And as usual, follow us on Instagram. Names is probably gonna be under us. Follow that, and we'll follow you back, and we're gonna be friends, right? Anyway, so today we will be giving you our unprofessional opinion on the movie Black and Blue. Starring Tyrese Gibson.
I have patches. Gibson.
And Naomi Harris. She's so beautiful. Let me do first things first.
Okay.
First things first. This movie's super boring.
It's the same.
It's generic.
It's the same. It's generic. It's fun.
First off, the opening scene, I was like, I hope this movie is not this tone. You know, she's jogging and the cops pull her like, hey, you fit the description. I'm like, okay.
Right.
So are we doing this whole black people hate cops and harassing black people? Like, I'm like, all right, we get it. But is it going to be this type of movie where we have to do this and be in I just hate when they pound on it. It's like, pour on it. It's like, don't do too much of that. Like, make a movie.
We know it's in the news.
It's in the culture. Like,
it's in the culture. And we love it when movies speak on it, but it's almost like slave movies.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be the same.
It's going to be the same repetitive thing. Exactly.
Until it's like drilled and it's like, we get it.
Yeah, we get it. Now make a regular movie, black people.
That's it.
Anyway, back to the movie. So it starts off with Naomi Harris. She comes back. She plays Alicia West. She comes back to her old neighborhood in New Orleans. And all her old homeboys and homegirls from high school is kind of like, you a cop. Fuck you. Like, I'm cool on you. Right. Like, you know, whatever.
You just smoke weed together. Now you this bitch.
But she's like a straight arrow cop. Like, you know, she wants to do right. You know, she's not, like, trying to be, I'm black or I'm a cop. She just wants the rules to be the rules.
She just happens to be a black woman who...
A cop. Yeah. And she just wants the rules to be the rules.
Basically.
She gets dissed by all her old friends from the neighborhood.
Her old neighborhood, completely.
So then, like, the boss is like, yo, I need somebody to do overtime. So she's kind of like, I'll do it. Because her partner is kind of like, man, I got date night. I ain't trying to do that. Yeah. So she's like, I'll do it. So she goes out and then she witnesses a murder.
Right.
You know what I mean? And that's when all hell breaks loose. Because it's like, oh, shit, I witnessed a murder. Are you black or are you blue? The name of the movie.
Exactly.
So she goes out. She witnessed a murder. And the person that killed the kid was played by Frank Grillo. His name is Terry Malone. He's a bad cop.
Right.
You know what I mean? They're in a drug gang with these kids. You know, they're pretty much, you know, the kingpins with the drugs. It's like, yo, we need you to sell the drugs. What's going good? Like, you know, whatever. So she ends up seeing him kill the nephew of Mike Coulter, whose name is Darius, played by Mike Coulter, who y'all know from Luke Cage.
Okay.
Yeah. So Luke Cage is a bad guy, yo.
Luke Cage is a bad guy.
He's a bad guy. Now, it's a cat and mouse chase. You know what I mean? Luke Cage is kind of like, yo. You know, Frank Grillo just told us that, you know, she did it. So put a hit on her. So she's trying to prove her innocence now. Like, I didn't kill him. They did it. And they set me up. It's a cat and mouse chase now.
And that's what made the movie shit. Because it's the same thing. I predicted it just by watching the previews.
Bro, remember they shot her? And, like, she was still, like, running and jumping over fences. Like, you got shot.
She had a vest on.
How? No. Fuck that vest. She got fucking bruised. She should have been healed.
No.
She could have lived. But she got shot so many times and then fell off a two-story building.
About her three backflips.
And you're hurt. But she's running around like she ain't got shot. She's jumping fences and stuff.
That's what
that was, like, unbelievable to me. I didn't like it. Anyway, So she ends up going to Tyrese. He helps her out. And then she's like, look, I just got to get to my partner because, you know, he'll have my back. But, you know, that's going to be predictable in this type of movie. You know, he's on the good. He's white. Dirty so he's cops. On the dirty cop side. You know, he's scared of him. Whatever the case may be, he ends up turning her in. You know, that was predictable. So then, like, anyway, the bad guys end up the dirty cops end up kidnapping Tyrese. He ends up telling them what really happened. They shut him up. I hate that in the movie. It's like, I can tell you what's going to happen, but right before I get to that point, you do something and I don't talk no more. Like, yo, all you got to do is say, he didn't do it, and everything will be clear. But they'll be like, he didn't do it. Shut up. Shut up. Don't say nothing else. And then you just like, it's kind of like, bro, finish your sentence. You know you could have finished this off by saying just those two words. But he didn't do it. And I hate when movies do that.
Bro. I honestly wish that they can actually take fans' approach to how movies should be based upon reality. Yes, this is happening in reality. Dirty cops, dirty politicians, everything. But put it in the aspects of, oh, this is really happening. I want to see a true story on it. A true story with the victims are still alive today or gone. But, come on. I don't know. It's up in my head.
This movie to me is don't watch, bro. I would.
Every time I saw
it's not trash. It's just a don't watch.
Every time I saw Tyrese, he looked like he was about to scream and cry in the movie.
This movie, yeah, it's a don't watch, man. It's like, it's predictable, generic. It's just, it's a don't watch, but it's not trash. I'm not going to say it's just the wackest movies ever made in 2019, but I wouldn't watch it. Do not watch it. It's a don't watch for JF. What you got, Rob?
Don't watch.
You got a don't watch as well. Like I said, the actors did a good job. Nobody, you just hate Tyrese.
Tyrese?
How you gonna act like that?
I don't know.
It's something about Tyrese.
Something about Tyrese, bro.
Yeah, I feel you, man. I mess with you, Tyrese. What's that shit he said when he was crying? What did he do when he was crying? Why you do me like that? What was the shit he said?
Oh. What more do you want from me? Come on, Tyrese. You have a Starbucks at your house.
What more do you want from me, Rob?
You have a Starbucks at your house. What more do people want from you? I don't know.
This movie's a don't watch.
Don't watch.
Just don't watch, people. And with that being said, like and comment on this video. And what more do you want from us, Real Culture? And like and comment. And we subscribe. Check out these other videos. What more do you want from us, Real Culture? We like and comment and subscribe.
Tyrese never grew a beard in a movie, ever.
But anyway, try. But that's it. Say it. Peace. And goodbye. No. What's up, man?